Hey everybody, and welcome back to the Evan Knits Things YouTube channel. I'm Evan, and I knit things. And this is podcast episode 15. Woo! So, I have a ton of WIP progress to talk to you guys about today. No finished objects, a little bit about the Knit Picks summer sale, and a couple acquisitions. So, let's jump right in with WIPs. So this week, I actually worked on every single WIP I have. Everyone. Can you believe it? I know. This is unprecedented. Unprecedented. It's crazy. So let me just open up my journal here and tell you how many WIPs I actually have. Okay, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 WIPs, and I worked on every single one of them. Now, not all of them got a ton of work done on them, but they all got worked on. So, as usual, I have just a pile of stuff over here off camera, so I'm just gonna grab what's on top and we will talk about it. I don't know what's on top, so let me see. No, we'll not talk about that yet. Not that. Okay, first up. Oh no, it's stuck on my microphone. Who knew? Okay. Up first is the Sea Glass sweater. This is by Woolen Pine Designs. And I am knitting this up entirely in scrap yarn. The main color I am holding throughout is 2 strands of fingering weight yarn. I have 2 different grays here that I'm holding together for the main color. And then the contrast color, I'm using tons of pink and purple and black scraps from my collection. Now, I didn't work very much on this. I did 1, 2, 3, 4 rows. You can see where my marker was before and where it is now. 4 rows. However, this week, the Woolen Pine released their Sea Glass cardigan, and I considered for a little bit this week. I considered scrapping this and doing the cardigan because they've come up with an ingenious way to deal with the ends. However, I did buy the pattern so I could like really do a deep dive into it. But I realized then you still have the same issue with the sleeves. So we're gonna stick with this, and I will probably also do a cardigan at some point. But I started then, got random embroidery floss, weaving in the ends to try to see if I could mitigate some of the disaster that was happening there. So I've done the ends from the beginning up to like down here. And I think it looks okay with what I'm doing. I tied the 2 color scrap ends together into a knot, and then I'm weaving it really loosely into the floats. So I don't know if you can see what I'm talking about there, but, and I don't think it looks bad. Like, it's kind of stiff, the fabric is stiff right there, but I think that should improve with blocking. And I don't think the stiffness is noticeable, because like down here where the ends are just sitting, like it's kind of a disaster. Like here you can see that like it's kind of pulling and it looks really terrible. So I think it'll be okay. We'll just have to wait and see. So I don't know how much this will get worked on this week, and I'll tell you why later. But here, I'll move my marker, and, yeah, that's the Sea Glass. So that's WIP 1, 1 of 8. It's number one. So one down, seven to go. Next. Giant pink blanket. This is the No Pearl Ribbed Blanket by Pearl Soho. I am knitting this up in all kinds of super bulky yarn from my collection. This pink is Bernat Softy Chunky in the colorway Hot Pink. I didn't put a marker on here last week as to where I was, but it was nowhere near this much. After last week's episode and realizing how little the polygon blanket is really helping with my scraps at the moment, I got really overwhelmed by the number of scrap bins that I have and the number of just general scraps that I have. And so I wanted to do something that I knew would actually work on some of them for a quick amount of time. So I picked up this, and I was also reading a physical book. So I needed to be able to not have to look at what I was knitting at all. And rather than use my purse project for that, which is really portable, I was working on this. So I did quite a bit on here. I will put a marker on here for next week. We use a pink marker, mostly just because the other markers I have in there are really small. So, okay, we'll put this right here. We'll see if we can even find this marker next week, because this thing is enormous. Although I did order a bigger needle. Like, this is a pretty short cable. Like, I think it's probably a 40-inch cable, but I ordered a 60-inch, so that should help. So that's that. Giant plank blanket. Progress made. Oh, also, quick aside, I guess, that I should have said at the beginning. Today is Monday, June 24th. I know previously podcasts have been filmed on Sunday and come out on Monday, but at least for the summertime, I'm going to film on Monday and release on Tuesday, just because that's a little easier for me. There's usually a lot going on with the kids and stuff on the weekend, especially with my older son and Boy Scouts and stuff. So we're going to film on Mondays, release on Tuesdays, until we're back to school. So, next project. This is the fuzz everywhere. This is the polygon blanket by Tin Can Knits. Interesting. I had knit four hexagons before. Last week I had these three, and this is Hedgehog Fibers Tweedy, and this is a Madeline Tosh. I discovered this week that it's Tosh DK, and both of these are DK weight and not worsted weight, so apparently I'm knitting a DK weight and a worsted weight blanket, and I'll tell you why here. Okay, so the yarn that Knit Picks sent me last week, their new yarn that I couldn't tell you about last week, but I was wrong and I actually could have told you about it, is this. This is their new yarn. Hold on, I have one with the ball band here. This is their new yarn, Oceana. By the way, I'm a Knit Picks affiliate, and there's a link in the description box below if you want to shop any of the things that I am telling you about. So if you shop the link, I make a small commission at no additional cost to you. It's super helpful for me. And yeah, I'd really appreciate it if you use the link if you wanted to get anything from Knit Picks. Before we keep talking about this, just really quick, it's their summer sale right now. It goes until mid-July. Currently, there is 60% off a whole bunch of yarns. Well, there's like 60% off, there's 50% off, there's 40% off, there's 30% off. So it's up to 60% off a whole bunch of things. They also have a code, That you can get 20% off new yarns. The new yarns change. I don't know if it's daily or weekly, but I'll put a little link when I'm talking about this yarn to the new yarn section, and you can check it out. But the code is KPNEW20, and you can get 20% off new yarns like this, the Oceana. They just came out with this. Since I am an affiliate of theirs, I talked to the affiliate director or whatever and was like, hey, that yarn's really cool. Do you want to send me some of that so I can tell people about it? And they were like, yeah, sure, we'll send you a couple balls. And so this is the Knit Picks Oceana. It's a worsted weight yarn. It is 54% super fine alpaca and 46% polyester from Sequal. And it's a worsted weight. It's 136 yards per 50 grams, and it's currently $11.99 a ball. And I know you're thinking, wow, that's really expensive for Knit Picks. It is, but here's why. So, this is made with Sequal, which, if you don't know what that is, it's recycled marine plastics. So, a company collects plastic from the ocean. In this case, it's from the ocean in the UK and around Europe. And then it is processed and recycled and made into fiber to then be made into yarn. And I think that's really, really fantastic. And so that's a lot of labor. And so the price obviously reflects that. But this yarn is really cool. It's really fuzzy. Like, you can see that halo. And it feels like a blown yarn, but it's not. It's plied. I have two colors here. This one, the pink, blue, purple, is Tigerfish. And this one, I lost the label. I don't remember what this one's called. I'll put it on the screen. What this one's called. So obviously I was gonna knit a hat with these, but they don't go together at all. So I decided I would put the green as part of my polygon blanket. Well, that's when I discovered that this is a worsted weight and these are a DK weight. See? This one's bigger. So, I think I'll still knit the rest of this into some of these, and I guess I'll have worsted weight scraps and DK weight scraps, and we'll just have to match sizes, and maybe we'll apparently be making two blankets. In imaginary land, did I ever finish this? Yeah. So, that's that. This yarn is really cool. You should check it out. I am going to buy myself another ball to go with this to make a hat. I think there's a really bright blue and there's a really bright like neon green too. So I think I may get two balls and do like a three color striped hat because I think it would be really cool looking. So stay tuned for that. So there's your Knit Picks summer sale update and your polygon update. Okay, what else do I have to talk about? Here we go. Skyline Pullover. This is by Tori Yu. The pattern, anyway. And I am knitting this up in yarn from Ruby and Rose's yarn. I am using her Fragrant Rose, which is her merino nylon cashmere base, and her Surrey alpaca base, And the colorways for the Surrey is Lucky Penny, and the Fragrant Rose, which is the cashmere fingering base, is colorway Bungalow. Now, I didn't knit a ton of this week, but I did knit some. So there we go. I was here at the Ducky, and I knit about that much. So not terrible. It's about, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 rounds. I knit 15 rounds on this past week. I'll take it, you know. I will. Slow but steady progress. This is so soft, though. I really, like, it's been, like, 95 degrees here all week, so I don't really want to wear this right now. But in general, I want it in my wardrobe. Sooner rather than later. But, you know, I have a lot of stuff going on right now, okay? A lot of stuff. So there's my quick little skyline progress. I knit a little bit. That's it. That's kind of how a lot of things went this week. I worked a little on this, a little on that, a little on that, a little on that. But you know, I worked on every single one of my whips, so we can say that none of my whips are currently languishing. Though I didn't bring up either of my Musselburgh hats to show you, like the Purse Project one is in my purse. And I did work on that when we ran some errands this weekend. And then the one for my husband, I still haven't finished the increases, but I did decide on the size that I was going to make. And so I know how many increases to do now. So that's that. Or wait, no, I did bring it. I did bring it. Okay, so this is the Musselburgh by Isolde Teague, and I did about that much. I think it was smaller than this last time you saw it. I think I need to get to 36 stitches in between the markers, and I'm at 26, so nearly there. And I am using Knit Picks Stroll, which is their basic fingering weight merino sock yarn. It's 75/25 merino nylon, and this is the color Midnight Heather. I do believe some of this is on sale in select colorways, so if you want to check it out. I actually have a whole sweater quantity of this in blacks and reds to knit a different sweater in. And I do have a sweater quantity of this as well. It's a really great sock yarn. I like it a lot. So that's that. Next project. I feel like this is going really fast, so apologies if it is. Next project. This is my Padstow test knit, which is for Victoria Marchant Knits. I am knitting this up in... Sorry, that was probably so loud. I knit this up in yarn from Red Door Fiber Studio. I'm using her alpaca sock base and her Surrey lace base. The sock base is the colorway Lavender Latte, one of a kind, and the Surrey lace is Misty Step. This week, I finished the body. And I did the collar ribbing, and I did the button bands, and I started the one sleeve. So there's the beginning of the sleeve, and I knit all of that. This has been 10 rows marker. So I did work on this decent amount. I stopped here because I needed to wind up another ball of yarn, and I didn't feel like doing it at whatever time this was. And then I forgot about it, and it sat on my couch for the rest of the week, and I didn't work on it. So I am almost done with this knit. I have 1 3/4 sleeves yet, but do you see the size of this needle? Like, it goes fast, okay? This is a 7 millimeter needle, which is a 10 3/4 US. So it's huge. This goes very quickly, but I do need to wind up my last skein of Surrey. I have plenty of the second ball of fingering left. I probably won't need another ball. No, I definitely won't need the third ball of fingering for this, but I do need to wind up the Surrey to be able to finish the sleeves, but I just haven't done that yet. Perhaps I will remember to do that this week. Maybe, maybe not. This, like I said, is a test knit, which is due September 23rd, but the launch day for the pattern is not until October 18th. So, more details on that to come. But this is so soft. It's so nice. It's a lot like the Lento in Gage, but it's a cardigan, and so I'm super excited about it. I wear my Lentos a lot. If I can ever get something off the needles, I may cast on another one. But there are too many things on my needles right now. I mean, I just said there were 8. That's really not that many, but whatever. Okay. Final whip this week. Or no, not final whip. Not final. Okay, since this is right here, let's talk cross stitch for a minute. Oh! I forgot to show you finished Ivysaur. Okay, I will take a picture when I'm done filming and I will put the finished Ivysaur up here so you can see it. Isn't he cute? He's all finished. Okay. So I finished Ivysaur, and then I started Espeon. And now Espeon is almost finished as well. I've got, like, I think there's actually 5 colors left, but, like, the middle of her eyes and the middle of her, like, jewel thing are 2 different colors, and they're, like, 3 stitches. So I think there's technically only 3 colors left if you want to not include those. Although it may be 4 and not, it doesn't matter, whatever. Ivysaur, Espeon is almost finished. And she's super cute. I like her a lot. So that's cross stitch. Okay, now final whip. Kutar Top by Sari Nordlund. Okay, so I had some issues with this. Last week I was looking at it and I was like, I don't know. Well, I didn't change the size, but I did have to rip it out because I realized that I made a mistake. And it was just easier to rip out 3 rows than it was to try to pick back the lace. So I restarted this. I didn't have to redo the cast on because it's a crochet provisional cast on, so that was really easy to pick up, and now I'm like 3 rows into the lace. Like, there's absolutely nothing for you to see here, but that's where we are in that. I haven't wanted to work on lace at all. I really want this in my wardrobe. I want to wear it right now. I just don't feel like knitting lace. So clearly this was not the right pattern for right now, but it's fine. I'm using fingering weight yarn that I have for this from dyers that don't dye anymore, so I really don't think it matters what it is. So that's whips you've seen and heard about and know about and whips. Now, new cast-ons. But not really new cast-ons, because it's not cast on yet. I've only swatched for it, but I have a new Pearl Soho project sample. And this is really big. It, like, okay, there's nothing in here but my swatch. So, like, obviously it doesn't look really big, but this is a really big project. So this is probably all I will be working on this week. It has a relatively short deadline. I have until July 24th. But I have an extremely busy week this week. And for the next couple weeks, I'm very busy. So like 99% of my project time is going to be spent on this because it's very involved and it's very large. And I can't tell you anything else. Yeah. So, that's that. Honestly, if this is the only thing I actually work on this week, then I probably won't do a podcast episode next week. Okay, let's just switch to life updates for a second here. My brother is getting married on Saturday. As you know, I have a chronic migraine disorder, which means that light and sound cause me severe pain, and then I generally have to spend a couple days in the dark in bed to recover after doing something that involves a lot of light and or sound. My brother is getting married outside on a farm in 92 degree weather on Saturday in the middle of the afternoon at 3 o'clock. So I'm anticipating doing really badly after that. So there probably won't be a podcast next week, just because I'm anticipating needing to recover. And any time I do have this week that's not dealing with wedding type things, I will be working on that sample knit that I can't tell you anything about. So that's really boring for you guys. The wedding's also an hour and a half away. So long car rides were already not my friend because I get really motion sick. So obviously I will be working on my purse project a lot. And that will probably get finished, actually. But, yeah. So I wouldn't anticipate a podcast next week. Stay tuned to Instagram for updates and things. So, now that we've talked about all the whips and things, iced coffee. Now that we've talked about all the whips and things, let's talk about what am I wearing? Okay. Do you recognize this knit? It's my Stria cardigan, and I finished it. And I fixed the sleeves so they're the right length. And I sewed the buttons on, and you probably can't see them because they're clear. The buttons are from Twin Mountain Handcrafts. And these are the clear glitter. I probably should have gotten the silver glitter because you just can't see them. You can't see them. But it's fine. They work. It's good. This fits pretty well now. Like it's a little long in the armpit area, but it's fine. I like it. I've worn it several times. More than several times since I fixed the sleeves to be not 8 feet long. And yeah. Oh, this is the Stria cardigan by Andrea Mowry. This is knit in random yarn from my collection. The gray is from a designer I don't support anymore. The purpley red, I never knew what it was. It was an unlabeled D-stash that I got for super cheap. And the blue stripe is from Explorer Knits and Fibers. It is their Denali sock base in the colorway Court of Dreams. So, that's what I'm wearing. I forgot to put on earrings because I'm a mess today. So, that's it. That's Twin Mountain Handcraft Buttons, Stria Cardigan. And I got myself this shirt for my birthday. If you know what it is, leave me a comment. Tell me your favorite line. If you don't know what it is, this shirt is from the movie Labyrinth, which was probably my favorite movie growing up. I watched it constantly. I mean, except like when I was really little. That doesn't count. But like, yeah. Like post Disney movie favorites, pre Napoleon Dynamite favorite. Labyrinth. Love it. Okay, let's move on to acquisitions. I have two acquisitions to tell you about this week. If you recall, last week I told you that I wanted to do a very small I-cord edging around my cottagecore crop that I finished, but I needed the smaller cordsmith. Got it. Shipping was so fast. I'm so excited. I'm never knitting an I-cord without one of these ever again. So I do have the regular size, and this is the mini. If you want to get one of these, they are made by Autumn Goodman at the Size Inclusive Collective. You can go to her website or on Instagram. I will have them both linked in the description box below. You should absolutely support her. The regular size fits any weight of yarn you want. The mini size is good for lace and fingering weight. I mean, you can totally use lace and fingering weight on the regular size as well. You'll just have a really fluffy, like fat I cord. This will give you a nice tight I cord on smaller yarns. So I am very excited to use this. I would like to do that this week, but I don't have time. So there's that. Second acquisition is my order from Super Glow Fibers from their Super Bloom collection came in. I got two skeins of their Super Sock base, which is a 90% superwash merino, 10% nylon. And I should have looked up how to say this name of this color before I did this, but there it is. If it's like a Spanish pronunciation, I would say it's Cholla. Cholla. I have no concept of how to say that correctly, so apologies. I took Spanish in high school, I took French in college, and then I was learning Spanish for a while in adulthood just for funsies. I can ask you for directions, I can tell you where things are. I can order food. That's about it. I can ask you about the library. That's about it. And you know, that's fine. And now I learn Japanese because I'm a nerd. So I did get these in. I am having a hard time deciding as to whether I will make a fingering weight held double beanie or a tank top. So, weigh in the comments. Like, I have plenty of other lime green in my collection that I could make a hat out of. Like, I have some right here, I have some over there, I have some over here, I have some over here that I could make a hat out of. And I have two of this that could be a tank. I don't know. I can't decide. It's also not in the cards right now to be casting this on, but those did come. Okay. We're a little out of order today, but let's talk goals. Well, we kind of already did, but we didn't talk about goals for this past week. So, this past week, I wrote down way more things that I could possibly finish just in case I finished things. And then there are things that I did that aren't on here. So I wanted to finish Ivysaur. Check, did that. I wanted to finish the Padstow body. Check, did that. I wanted to finish the Padstow collar and button bands. Check did that. Then I also wrote down both sleeves just in case I got there. I love checking things off, but I didn't. I wanted to start Espeon. I did that. I wanted to work on 10 rounds of my Skyline. I did that. I wanted to do 10 rounds of my Sea Glass. I did not do that, but I did 5 or 4 or something, and then worked on the end management. I wanted to do 2 colors on Espeon, and I did way more than that. I wanted to do 1 hexagon for my polygon, and I did that. And I wanted to swatch for my new sample, and I did that as well. So, I have written 4 things down for goals for next week. Work on the sample, finish the Padstow sleeve if I have time, finish Espeon if I have time, and weave in some Sea Glass ends if I have time. All of these things are entirely based on if I have time. Although I can totally do that Padstow sleeve today because I am waiting for my second swatch for the Pearl Soho sample to dry. So I can't start that yet until I've submitted my swatch and gotten approval to start the project. And I don't actually have the pattern yet because they're still finalizing some things. So, but today I do have to edit this video. So if I have time after editing this video today, I will work on my Padstow or possibly Espeon, depends on how I'm feeling. Then other non-knitting goals this week. I need to do my nails. I need to do my toenails because I'm wearing open-toed shoes to the wedding. I need to dye my hair because this is not great. There are going to be tons of pictures. But yeah, there's a lot to do this week. I will have a lot of ironing of everybody's clothes to do later in the week. And just, it's a lot. It's a lot. I'm kind of stressed out. I hate big events. I'm very pleased that my brother has found himself a person that he loves. But yeah, lots of stress. Anyway, so I'm considering adding to the podcast a books section. What I'm reading right now, what I've read recently, what I liked, what I hated. Let me know what you think about that. If you'd like a books section. Let me know. Do just a super quick one right now. I am reading the Wings of Fire series by 2E.T. Sutherland with my older son. There are 17 books. I finished book 5 this past week. They're broken up into like 5 books go together, 5 books go together, 5 books go together, and then there's 2 little offshoots. So I've read the first 5 book chunk that's like about all the same characters, and then the second 5 book chunk has different characters but same world and it's all interconnected. So I finished the first 5 books. I liked them. They're fine. I mean, they're children's books, but he really likes them and wanted to tell me everything about everything, and I didn't know what he was talking about, so I figured I'd read them. They're shortish. So I read the first 5. I liked them, but I'm taking a break between the next ones, and I am reading... I started The Stormlight Archive by Brandon Sanderson. I am about 15% of the way into Way of Kings. What is happening? I don't know. Kaladin's fine. I like him. I guess he's fine. I want to know more about his little wind spirit friend. And the girl who we follow, whose name I cannot currently remember. They're always talking about Safe Hand and Free Hand, and they cover their Safe Hand, but this has never been explained, and I don't know what that means, and it's driving me insane. Like, I understand you don't want to tell me everything about everything in a high fantasy world all at once, but like, when you keep saying it and don't explain it at all, it drives me crazy. Like, It's fine for like big world building stuff. Like you don't need to tell me the whole history of everything and like even how the whole magic system works up front. I know we'll get to that, but when you keep saying like she did whatever with her safe hand and that it's covered and with her free hand, can you please just explain why, what that means? Like it's really bothering me. Like really a lot. Okay, so I'm reading that. And I'm also reading Elizabeth Hunter's Elemental Mysteries series, which is a vampire romance series. I finished book one, which was A Hidden Fire. I finished that earlier in the week, and then I started book two, This Same Earth, yesterday or the day before, and I'm about halfway through it. Because I've been having massive insomnia this week, so I've had plenty of time to lay in bed and read on my Kindle. And I really like it, but this is like the slowest slow burn in the history of the world, and it's driving me crazy. Like, it's so slow. Like, oh, will they? No. Will they? No. We'll just keep waiting. We'll just keep waiting. Anyway, my husband and I also listen to books together, and we are currently doing the we've been working through Throne of Glass for forever. Well, we stopped to read Crescent City 3 when it came out. But it was a really busy season. And that took us like literally 6 months to read. So we're back to Throne of Glass now. We are doing the tandem read of Empire of Storms and Tower of Dawn because I hate Kaol and I couldn't handle an entire book about just him again. Because I've read these books already, but he hasn't. So we listen to those together in the evening for about an hour before bed. So it takes a really long time to get through books, but we're doing that. And that's all the books I'm reading right now. Oh, I did also this week, Riley Sager's latest book, Middle of the Night, came out. At the beginning of June, and I was able to finally get hold of that this week, and I did listen to that as well. It's been a while since I listened to a thriller. I did like it. I hated the end. I'm reading a lot of things. Let's look at my last time I colored in my bookshelf here. It's been a while, so I know it's not accurate right now. But I believe I'm up to 89 books now. But the whole first page is 82, and then it actually only goes up to 173, so I may need more than that. But I think I'm over here now. But, okay, I said this was gonna be a short book thing. It wasn't. So, sorry if you weren't interested in talking books. You can't ask me about books or knitting and expect me to not talk for an hour. But yeah, that's everything for this week. So, thanks for stopping by. I hope you enjoyed this podcast episode. Click the like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and head over to Instagram and follow me over there. And I will see you next time. Bye!